Afghanistan, an ancient civilization with an age-old history and culture. Peaceful and serene. The war ravaged the whole countryside. The fabric of Afghan society was torn apart by the cruelty of war and its related destruction. And the most affected by this cruel change are children and women. For them, their entire life has been affected. Today, they face a grim battle for survival. When women from Afghanistan were facing a crisis of survival and sustainability, another group of women came forward to help. Seva, with its philosophy of supporting women to make them self-reliant and independent, extended a helping hand across the border. They decided to help women from Afghanistan by giving them vocational training of income-generating trades like sewing and garment making. Seva believes that armed with proper training, women can support the family and improve the quality of life by earning more money. Groups of women came from Kabul with lots of expectations and uncertainty about the unknown. But these Afghan women met their fellow well-wishers. And the bonds of a new beginning started with an orientation program given by trainers of Seva at the Trade Facilitation Center, the TFC.
So we are six person in my family, and my mother, my father do job, and my brother study medical faculty in urban country, and also I don't have any job, but after going of me in Afghanistan, I will do this job, and I will get incoming from this way, and it is good for also too for economic of my family, especially when I have income, I can use from this to my personal wants which I have. I can resolve my personal some wants, some demand which I have.
Before I told you that I'm working in the non-governmental organizations deals, and my incoming salary was normal, that I can keep it my family, this was a normal that's incoming.
These women from Afghanistan had creative dreams and a desire to create something new. The foundation of these creations was laid with a paper exercise. The first lesson was to develop a steady hand on a sewing machine. They started practicing with zeal, sometimes on a straight line, and at other times crisscrossing the path of knowledge. A knowledge imparted by the expert trainers of TFC, who worked with them on a day-to-day basis, leading them through the theory and practice of garment production. The next was to learn how to join two pieces of cloth. To learn that different seams are used for different purposes. A flat seam gives a good finish, and a double finish a strong bond. Not only that, each seam needs and uses different threads, different stitches, different needles on a sewing machine. And then to solve the mysteries of the electrical sewing machine. How to thread a machine, how to change a needle, to use an electrical machine, and that also was conquered. All good things and good steps are taken measure for measure, and so it was here as well. They learn to take measurements for garments, gents' shirts, women's salwar kameez, bags and other accessories. They learned that all of this have to be measured before they can be put to cloth. Before they can be transferred to cloth, they have to be designed, paper cuttings made, and a choice of fabrics made. Then came the stitching of garments. Here the women were given orientation by staff from the leading Fashion Institute of India. The teachers of the National Institute of Fashion Technology explained various concepts and styles. To introduce them to a scientific, organized and industrial mode of garment production, these women from Afghanistan were given an orientation tour and training at NIFT. They visited the library and were able to see books on fashion, designs, creative input, as well as the catalogues of industrial houses. They saw the portfolios of final year students to get an idea of how theoretical knowledge is applied to the world of fashion, how different types of cloth is used based on its weight, color and texture. They were introduced to the concept of a total garment. Armed with this knowledge, these women from Afghanistan then set out to design and produce garments for themselves. Garments made for themselves will be a first step towards self-reliance and independence once they go back home. But learning is an eternal process, and once they go back, the learners of today will become the teachers of tomorrow.